I grew up with Vreni Schneider, and she was always my big idol when I was little. I still remember her with her cheese suit and the special flame yellow slalom suit she wore. She was more of a slalom and giant slalom skier, although she also did some podiums in speed events. But I remember I always wanted to be like her, and she's like, that's just, she's a legend. And I have this autograph card that is on the wall in my living room, and it's her with all her Olympic world champs and medals and the globes she won, like World Cup globes. And the table is full. I mean, it's so impressive. And I was always like, okay, if I would have a table like that, it would be empty. Right now there's one medal, so at least something. But still, I mean, this comparison says it all. And I was very lucky to meet her when I was young on a kids race in Switzerland, a national kids race. And that photo is also in my living room with her and me and Michael von Grüningen, another great Swiss champion. And yeah, that's just the things you grow up with, the idols you grow up with. And nowadays she's a good friend and I admire her so much, and she's just such a great person. She featured in quite a lot of Olympics, 88 with all the Swiss medals in Calgary, and then 94, I think she was the last Swiss female alpine Olympic champion in Lillehammer in slalom. And just too much to remember, so many medals and so many victories. I was 9 years old. I remember Lillehammer was such a beautiful Olympics, and she just charged it. And for me, that was always like the highlight of the week, to watch the races. And my parents didn't allow us to watch so much TV when we were kids, but sports was always good. So on the Olympics, the TV was on 24/7. I think she was very humble. That influenced me for sure a lot. She was hardworking, as far as I felt or as I thought, and that always inspired me to work harder. And a lot of people always told me, you have to have the killer instinct to be really good. And I was never like that. And she was always an example for me to do it very good, but in another way. I'm not saying that this was bad to have a killer instinct, but just to be able, without a killer instinct, to do really outstanding things. I think she was very, very smooth skier, maybe like a cat. She always had this little bump in her back when she was racing, or like a boxer. And it was really an awesome mix between aggressive and smooth skiing. And it just, like, in those days, it was like she was flying down the course. I mean, it looked so easy when she was doing it. And with those skis back then, it was not so easy, right? And I mean, still now, she would be awesome, even with the new skis. If you compare the races of her with people who ski now with 155 slalom skis, and she still looks great. I mean, that says it all. Yeah.